Hi everyone and welcome back to the Floss Marketing School. In this video, we are going to see how you can measure e-commerce within Matomo Analytics and measuring in fact multiple items. So that's probably one of the most technical videos that I will do. So of course, you know e-commerce within Matomo Analytics, so it just consists in recording every transaction made on your website. So you have different features that you can activate. The one that we're gonna have an interest in is the classic e-commerce tracking code. And in fact, so far I covered how you can do e-commerce tracking, but just when just one single item is in concern. So typically this given tracking code though, what's gonna happen when you have in fact multiple items that you would like to add to a cart and that you would like to record? This is where it comes to be a little bit more difficult. Okay, so this part when it comes to the loop is in fact the most difficult part. This is the one that most of the analysts will struggle with. This is the one where, as I said, here you can add other products in the order, but the big question is how can you make this? So most of it, I don't think you can do it with a tag manager. No, I think you can, but it's kind of even more technical than doing it from the server side. And in this video, I'm going to show it from the server side way. For this, I'm using the WooCommerce plugin of WordPress. And so that's why I strongly recommend you to have an e-commerce website that you can break. So WordPress is a very good one for that. And once you will get your WooCommerce running, what you need is the Rosetta Stone. And this is the Rosetta Stone, in fact, giving you all the different functions that you can call in order to be able to extract the data out of the database and to make them available within Matomo Analytics. And as well, you may need some help from a developer. So here once more, I really thank Lucas Winkler for all his help. And as well, you may need to look out within forums. And in my case, I look through the Google Analytics e-commerce tracking code in order to find the last byte on which I was struggling with, which was about getting the SKU. Okay, so let's get started. So I have an e-commerce. This is my my e-commerce website. Here I strongly recommend you that once you install WooCommerce, that you install as well a plugin which is called the Temp Templates, which will give you an access directly to your file within WooCommerce. And the one that you have an interest in is the thank you page. So that's the template of my thank you page. And this is where in fact I can add the Matomo tracking code. As you can see, the Matomo tracking code for me is starting over here and then ending up here down below. So here I inserted in fact the classic Matomo Analytics tracking code that in fact I split in different parts. So here's the first part of my script. Then I added the PHP function, and this is the most complicated part. In fact, this is where you need to have a loop. So this is what Lucas did for me. And for each order that you have, you get the items. So in fact, those, you cannot find them on your own. You need the Rosetta Stone that was showing over here in order to know what are the different function that you need to call within WooCommerce in order to make those variables available. And thanks to those variables which gets available, then you can make your script. And then within your script, then this is where you call the different variables. In my case, it's calling out, in fact, the SKU, which is the most complicated one, because the SKU is linked to the product and not the item in itself. And then for the rest, then you are just calling, in fact, the different function of WordPress. Then you do the pack track e-commerce order, which as well, is this one is kind of easy because on the thank you page, you get direct access to those data. So you just need here to call back the order number and the get total. And that's how it works. So that's in fact what you can see here. So in order to get this data, you need the WordPress function, which have been designed in order to push out here the order ID and the total and so on and so forth for the different items. So Let's see that in practice. So what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna go on my store. So I'm gonna go on my shop. Okay, I'm gonna order, for example, let's say like I'm gonna order like 6 of this one, and I'm gonna order as well. I'm gonna order as well this one. I'm gonna take as well many of those. So let's see. So once more, I really like WooCommerce because here you can in fact make transactions, and the transaction that you're gonna make, you can pay by check or anything like this. So here I have what I want. So two bracelets, 4 luggage tag, and 7 wood postcard. I proceed to the checkout, and through the checkout, so I got all my data, and I can place the order. So check payments, and this is my thank you page. And on this thank you page, I can look at the source code, and what do I got? As you can see here, I have my script, then I have the pack add e-commerce item. So I ordered 2 bracelets that you can see over here. Here, 1 luggage tag and 1 wood postcard. That's funny, as you can see here, because it seems that that the count of the quantity is not right, but the price over here is right. So okay, I got something wrong somewhere, and for the rest it seems okay. So yeah, the total here is right. Oh okay, that's WooCommerce issue, it seems, because this is not what I ordered. I ordered more than those. Let's see, how I did it. Your cart is empty, so I'm gonna return to the shop. I'm gonna add those back. One of these. I'll go over here. I'm gonna purchase 8 of this one and 3 of this one. Okay. Oh. And this is probably where the mistake is. Okay. Oh, maybe that's because I'm out of stock on it or something like this. Well, that's really strange that actually WooCommerce is not picking the quantity correct, but Matomo on his side is doing the count right, as you can see. I mean, I'm just looking at the quantity over here, but the quantity should be correct. Yeah, you see, so there's no error actually from the Matomo side, it's just on my WooCommerce. I don't know, something is going wrong, but now I can in fact double check over here. And as you can see, I got all the different purchases that I made, so it's working fine. And how is it possible that it's working fine? Once more, it's just because within my template, I made in fact the different call to the database. And in order to be able to do the first call properly, you need to have your loop working properly. So this is why most of the time, one say that you need to have a developer, because those are fully written in PHP, and just one mistake can in fact break your page. I can give you just one given example. Let's imagine that I'm removing the A here, and that I'm saving the template. If I just access back to this checkout page, and that I refresh the page, as you can see, the page is totally broken. Okay, it's not going to be displayed, in fact. So that's why most of the time, this given code that I'm showing you here is more the developer doing it, because you need to call the right function at the right time in order to call the database, and as well you need to have a code which is 100% Correct, and that's everything that I wanted to show you for today. So it's just about this given loop for each in order to call properly your database and get one item per to list all the items which are recorded within the transaction. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.